he was very democratically selected because people have not read the original text. So do you know what happened exactly? So he called a lot of kings from other janpadas, means other kingdoms, other smaller kingdoms which are under the jurisdiction of Ayodhya or under the jurisdiction of Kosala. He called all of them. Dashrath ji called all of them. He called a lot of people's representative also, right? So a lot of kings were called, a lot of people's representative were called, right? And then Rama's name, Bipal, was proposed, right? On different counts. Will he be a good king? Will he be take care of the boundaries? Does he understand economy? Does he understand justice? Is he popular? Does people love him or not? On various counts, his name was proposed. And then various breakout groups were made, RP. Right? Various breakout groups, like, you remember in workshops we do breakout groups, like some small group discuss separately. They all discussed, they all came back and ratified the name of Rama. That was a long exercise. And then Rama's name was finally finalized, right? That Rama will be the king tomorrow. Let's do the coronation tomorrow. Okay. And the whole city was happy because everyone used to love Rama anyway, right? He was the most popular anyway, right? If there were to be voting, the voting system as we have today, and I know the elections are coming in your country, US, a lot of you from US very soon, I think in November. I follow US politics quite closely. So if there were to be voting, Rama would have been selected because he was so popular, right? Everybody was happy, the whole city was celebrating, right? Whole city people were celebrating. They were distributing sweets, they were decorating, they were thinking what they will wear tomorrow. But one person was not happy. Who was that one person who was not happy? Okay, I think you know, man number two is Mantra. So Mantra was not very happy. Mantra comes to Kekai and say, okay, hey lady, why are you so happy? She says, no, Rama is getting coronated tomorrow. My son Rama is getting coronated tomorrow. No, Rama is not your son. Your son is Bharat. No, but for me, all four of them are my son. No. You know what will happen? Dashrata will die soon and Kaushalya will become the main queen and you will be treated like second-rate citizen, right? And she poisoned her mind. Kekai also used to love Rama like anything. We remember she gifted Kanakamahal, remember? The Kanak Palace, the Golden Palace, right? And then finally Mantra was able to poison Kekai's mind and Kekai finally got convinced. And that, oh my God, right? Oh my God, that Ram was about to be the king and now there's a major twist, right? Remember what was the twist in Balkan? The twist in Balkan, Vishwamitra coming and asking for very young, 14, 15 years old, Rama and Lakshmana, right? And now, the twist is, Rama is about to become the king, and then this thing happens. Now, Dashrata didn't know what to do. Dashrata did not know what to do. He has given these two promises, long back to Kekai, and now Kekai asked these two promises, two boons. You know what did she ask? She asked two things. She said, make my son Bharat as the king and send Rama to exile, to Vanvas, to forest for 14 long years. Let's become, right, you want to be Dashrata for a while? Just tell me that making Bharata the king was enough, right? Why to send Rama to 14 years of Vanvas? Why you think Kekai might have thought that? Maybe, okay, okay, she want, okay, that okay. My son
can
should
we
be,
all go to
Rama can also coexist in there. Rama can also live there, right? But why she wanted
Dashrata for a while?
What do you think, Lara? Let's why, see what why you would have wanted done if you were Dashrata. And don't give me good answers. Touch your heart and give me a real answer.
Chose Rama.
A lot of kings chose Rama.
And what you would have done?
Majority wanted Rama, right? So, okay. What do you think? Why she wanted Rama to be away also? So that, yeah, people will forget Rama. So that, like, Rama may not come back. Rama is out of sight, out of mind. We call it, right? You heard this phrase? Out of sight, out of mind. Nobody, Rama cannot come back. If Bharata does something wrong also. So basically, she wanted to secure Bharata's position at the throne very formally, right? So that Bharata is the king for sure, but Rama is not even around people, right? People, right? Or maybe she may not feel guilty, right? And this is the picture. Dashrata agreed to the demands. And you know what is the principle why he agreed to the demands? Because, and that's my next leadership lesson, very, very important in life. That shows what our character is. We are from the land of Rama. We are from the land of Dashrata. Because promise is a promise. That's my next leadership lesson. Then you don't judge. Will I be better off if following the promise? Or will I be worse off following the promise? Will it benefit me? Will it not benefit me? Promise is a promise. You have done the promise, right? Promise, walk the talk. Some of you who know this, a very famous chotpai from Tulsi Ramayana, let me recite it. I'm sure you must be knowing it. Raghukul reet sada chali aayi, pran jaye par vachan na jaye. Let me translate it for you. Raghu was one of the kings in Ishvaku dynasty. And he was known for keeping his promises, right? And it was the tradition in Raghukul, in Ishvaku dynasty, in Ayodhya, in Kosala Empire, that a promise is a promise, right? You can lose your life, but you will not go back on the promise. That's how promise was for them, right? And that's why I get goosebumps whenever I talk about these stories. These are real men and women. They were extraordinary men and women. That's why we are talking about them, Divyang. They were not simple people. We are talking about Divyang, about them after 14,000 years. You know, Ramayana happened almost around 14,000 years back, Amrita. It happened almost 14,000 years back. I'll send you videos how the dating of Ramayana is done. How you can find out when Ramayana exactly happened. It's a historical text. After 14,000 years, so many of us are sitting in front of the computer and talking about Rama, Lakshman, Sita, because they were extraordinary men. Mridula, from morning to evening, don't we break so many promises, small promises, within our family, to our sister and brothers, to our parents to us to parents, we to friends, we to teachers, brothers, sisters. Don't we break promises, right? But we are from the land of Rama and Sita. For us, the learning is that promise is a promise and walk the talk, right? Let me see what are you talking in chat. Right? Oh, okay, you agree with me. There's no practicality then. There's no judging. There's no weighing the balance. Oh, will it beneficial for me? Will it not beneficial for me? Do the promise a little carefully. If you want to be a little practical, make the promises a little carefully. But once you've done the promise is a promise, right?